In our next example, we have two new variations on Mendel's inheritance patterns. They are codominance and multiple alleles. In order to look at both of these, we're going to use the example of the ABO blood type in humans, which is a gene located on chromosome 9. Now, if you know your blood type, you might know whether you're A positive or O negative. The positive and negative is a separate gene, and there are actually dozens of genes that code for different sorts of blood types. We're just looking at one. And this one gene has three different alleles instead of the two that we're used to working with. We have two dominant alleles and a recessive allele. And by convention, our dominant alleles are usually notated with capital letters. So we'll do the same here. But since we have two of them, we need a way to differentiate. And to do that, we're going to use superscripts. So our first big I is going to get a superscript A. Our second one is going to get a superscript B. And our third allele is the recessive allele, so that one will get a little letter, a little I. Now, what these alleles actually code for, if this is a red blood cell, recall that there are little carbohydrate identifier tags on the outside of your cells, and red blood cells are no different. If a person has an allele for A, that means that they produce an enzyme that slightly modifies these carbohydrate tags. So we'll say these have the A modification. If a person has the B allele, they produce an enzyme that alters their little carbohydrate tags slightly differently. So we'll just notate those as little Bs on the outside of the red blood cells. The I allele has a mutation, and that mutation is a deletion, which caused a frame shift, which means that the protein, the enzyme, doesn't fold properly, and it has no enzymatic activity. So these red blood cells will still have the carbohydrate tags on them, but there's no enzyme to modify them, so we're going to leave those blank. So we have three alleles instead of just two. That's what multiple allelism means. The codominance refers to the fact that neither the A nor the B allele can mask the other dominant allele. So if an individual has two dominant alleles, they're going to express both equally. Okay, so let's look at the four possible phenotypes and their associated genotypes. A person could be type A, type B, type AB, or type O. And if a person has type AB blood, there are two possible genotypes. They might be homozygous, in which case they would have big I A, big I A, or they could be heterozygous, big I A with a little I. Similarly, a person with the type B phenotype can be homozygous or heterozygous. If a person has type AB blood, there's only one option for their genotype. They have an IA and an IB. So their red blood cells are not going to look like any of these. What they will have is a combination of A's and B's. And then our last possibility, a person with type O blood has two recessive alleles. Before we move on, think about this. Is it possible for a person with type AB blood to have IA, IB with a little I? And the answer is no, it's not. Because even though there are three alleles in the gene pool, each person can only have two at a time. They got one from their mom and one from their dad. So you can only have two at a time, which means having three alleles is not possible assuming that everything in meiosis went the way it should have gone. Okay, now that we have our phenotypes and genotypes, let's try a practice problem. If a woman with type O blood has a child with a type AB male, what are the chances that the child would inherit his or her mother's blood type? And then what are the chances that the child would inherit its father's blood type? So let's figure out the genotypes of our parents. We have a woman with type O blood, and for type O blood, there's only one possible genotype, so we know that she must be little I. She is going to have a child with a type AB male, and for type AB, there's also only one possibility, so we're going to cross her with a male that is IA, IB. Since this female only has one allele, right, she has two little I's, so every single gamete that she produces is going to carry a little I. But for the male, half of his gametes will carry that IA, the other half will carry the IB. So in making our Punnett square, we can put the little I on one side and our dominant alleles across the top. Fill in our squares and then answer the question, what are the chances that the child would inherit his or her mother's blood type? So in this first square we have a child that is IA with a little I, so that would be a type A child. And over here we have IB with a little I, so that child would have type B blood. The mother's blood type was type O, so there is zero chance that any child would inherit its mother's blood type. And the father in this scenario had type AB blood. Neither of these potential offspring have type AB blood. So same thing with the fathers. There is a 0% chance that these offspring would match either their father or their mother's blood type.